Alles goed? Ja. Ik zie geen flikker. Ja, joehoe! Oké, eentje. Meteen scherp, hè? Wauw, te gek dat jullie allemaal zijn. Heel leuk. Who of you is actually from abroad? Okay, so maybe I should speak in English because hi. So who of you speaks Dutch?
Dutch.
I don't know. Should I do my stories in English? Wie spreekt er geen Engels? Ja, dat kan. I'll just play, hè? Thank you. And I need you. I recently made my idiot papers, so to speak, digital. But I make pictures of my of my idiot papers. So I scribble and make a lot of mess. I make a picture of it, and it makes sense to me. So for this one, I need my scribbling. Yeah, I'm so modern. And I'll do a song not from the 80s. Full of flowers, it's amazing. You know all those flowers, they come from Holland. Yeah, yeah. Hoe heet dat ook alweer? Waar kom je vandaan?
Aalsmeer.
Ik kom van Aalsmeer. Yeah, they go all the way through and then you come back. So next song, I'll try to, it's a Dutch language song, I'll try to explain a little bit in English. Next song is a song from one of my favorite Dutch singers in the world. It's called Gerard van Maasappels. Yeah. Because we're in Brabant, so everybody knows him. Well, anyway, he's very famous in Brabant anyway. So, but he's a little bit older. When I was young, when I was a kid, he had an album of him, a few albums of him, and my parents had. So, and I used to listen to. And there was one song in particular I loved from this album, and it's kind of a melancholic story about a woman who lives in a village. And she's a little bit old, and I know every village and every city has those people, or at least one, that are a bit old and a bit, you know, out of the ordinary, and they drink too much, and they are a bit weird, and everybody really understands them. But they are there, and they make kind of life really more colorful, you know, because they are not like we are. So the song is about a lady. But you know, I grew up in a village called Sibius Castle. It's not so far away from here. And we had a man in our village like that. And actually this man lived in my street. And he used to have animals behind his house. So he had like cages with pigs and rabbits and chicken, and they had lots of. But I loved to go there. I always went there when I was young. And he was, in my beliefness, he was very old. So he must have been like 60, whatever. And he also drank. He drank so much that the company, the brewer company, they would every weekend pass by his house with the truck and stack up the crates of beer in his hallway. And it would take him a week to drink it, and they'd come back. So that's how much he drank, and he always smelled like beer. But I loved going there, and we would sit on the kitchen table, and he would give me like tea and yeah, I can't drink, but a koetjesreep. All the Dutch people know what I'm talking about. They're horrible, right? But it's not. It's really ill. So, but he did, like, for years and years, I got tea in the koetsjesreep. And it was awful, but I love coming in. And I don't know, I can't really recall what we were talking about. Because what do people talk about when they're like, 12 and then 65? So I probably talked a little about like school or whatever. But then again, so I was there, and I also fed his pigs. I would give them food, and I would pet them, and so I loved it. But sometimes Willem, his name, he was so drunk in the night, he would feed his animals, and then we'd go to sleep. But then he was so drunk that he let the cages open, and then in the night, and it happened so many times that in the night, the pigs would wander around the streets, and there was one guy across from Willem, exactly across from Willem. The most neat and tidy guy ever lived there. So the pigs, of course, they went out of their cage and they go straight to his garden and make like a huge mess. So there's, and then you know, of course you wake up in the morning and there's like lots of racket going on in the streets. So there's never a dull moment with Willem. But of course, one day he passed away because, you know, people like that don't, well, sometimes they do, but they really don't really get very old because he was not a very healthy man. But he was colorful and he was nice and I loved him very much. So this song, I love it and I've been listening to it all my life and I'll try to play it now. It's called Sis van Hoek. And now I talk so much, I have to concentrate.
Thank you.
happy, this shame reaction on yeah. Big rock bands in the world, yeah. You can sing along. I know everybody knows the chorus. Don't be shy. Yeah, I know. You're all like 70s and 80s kids here. Just like me.
My life. It's okay, shall I do one more?
Then we have a little break, a little beer or a cup of coffee, whatever you want. Cigarette outside, I don't know. Then we come back. We'll do some more. Okay? Yeah. Music he would play at his funeral and everything, the whole story. I was 10 o'clock in the morning and I had just done a gig the night before, so it was a bit like this. And I didn't eat yet. So I listened to his story. And then he rushed off. He came back with a cup of coffee. And he said, yeah, it's for you. So he bought me a cup of coffee. And then he rushed off again. And I stood up, and meaning to tell him, like, I don't drink coffee. But I couldn't, because he was so nice to me, you know? And so I thought, okay, so I don't say this, but what do I do? So I had to drink the cup of coffee. And so I drank it out of politeness. And I drank the whole thing in one go. Because I thought, let's just be done with it. And all of a sudden, it was like, oh. And then I understood the meaning, the effect, the meaning of why, like, millions of people in all over the world drink coffee. It's just the effect, right? It's not tasty at all. It's just waking you up. So I was like, oh. And from that moment on, I sometimes drink coffee when I have to be somewhere and all of a sudden be shocked, because I'm not shocked by nature. And it works. It works like a train. So, coffee. I once wrote a song that I don't drink coffee. I have another coffee story. There was this one time at Bandcamp. There was a one time I worked with somebody, another politeness story. I worked with somebody for like a few years and we made music. It was always like overseas and he was in America and I was here, blah, blah. We did a lot of music together. So he starts sending me presents for Christmas and when my son was born. He sent me like a huge stuffed animal and it's like, and then he sent me, once Christmas, he sent me this like a huge box full of coffee. And it was like coffee from all over the place, like expensive shit, you know? So I thought, what do I do? Because, you know, in Holland, you must know, people are so honest. So for us, it's natural to say, oh, I'm sorry, I don't drink coffee. Do you want a bag? Or, you know, we have nothing with like, okay, I'll just, you know, whatever, keep it in the cupboard for 12 years and whatever. So I wanted to write an email like, oh man, thanks so much, must be really expensive, but you know, I don't drink coffee. And then I thought, that's not polite, is it? So I wrote a song for him on the computer with like a drum beat. With the keywords and the whole thing, and the whole lyric was, I don't drink coffee. So I sent him the song. I've never heard anything. So, yeah, we kept on working together for a few years, but I just never had a reaction. But I also know people from the US are very polite, you know, they're very much like, just don't say anything, just lie to me, you know, just say you like the coffee, but I did the total opposite, so. I don't know, maybe you didn't like, well, I made a song, right? That's nice, isn't it? So it's polite, impolite, politeness, I don't know. I'll think about it.
Okay, let's do a song.
Beautiful one. Shines in the sun.
Thank you.
is the most messy version ever. So, okay. Bruce Springsteen.
Oh, I missed this one.
Again, you may sing along. This is the most nerve-wracking thing ever on earth is playing on that show. Because bands or music, they get 1 minute to play, and it's a talk show, they have a little bit of music, and it's 1 minute for every artist. So you're there, it's live, it's prime time, and it's like 1 in 15 people in Holland watch this program. So myself included, because I always watch it, and sometimes I'm on the other side. It's strange. Like, I was there multiple times, but this one time I did this song, and it went very well. But the time before that, when you do the song is fucking nerve-wracking. And so I come from the south, and that show is in Amsterdam, so you have to kind of drive a long way. And I was in traffic, so I was late. And there was like, they have the rehearsals, and then you have to go on television live. And the rehearsals, I was like rushing, and I just made the rehearsals. And we just did like a rushed rehearsal, like, yeah, okay, we get a sound, okay, go upstairs, you do the makeup. And then with all the turmoil, I thought, just when they said to me, okay, we have to go down now, you wait for the show, and then there's like a commercial, and then you have to sit, and you have to sit through the whole show, and then in the very end, it's your turn. So I go downstairs, and then I realize, oh shit, I didn't think about how I'm gonna do my minute, because there's a song of 3 minutes, then I have to shorten it, but I have to make like a good like tension bow, we call it. So you have the beginning, and like a crescendo, and an end, blah, blah. And I was thinking, oh my God, and then I sit in the show, and I keep thinking, like for an hour long, I think like, okay, so what do I do? Okay, then I sing this, and then I sing, how do I end it? And I was so nervous. And then they called me on the table, and we, you know, with the two, I'm looking at you all the time, because you saw it. And I'm seeking for support. And so I sit there, this will become a long story, but I sit there, and they call my name, and I have to sit on the desk, on the table. And another thing is that Matthijs van Nieuwkerk, the host, is a really nice guy. I like him very much. And it's also nerve-wracking just to look him in the eye. And he's asking me all these questions, and I just answer without knowing what I'm saying. So I was thinking about this chord, and then this song, and this, and then. And he says, okay, so give it away. And then I thought, okay, then I'll end with this chord. And then I do the whole thing. And my husband was there, and he was above in the green room. And I thought, oh, okay, I got through it. That's what I thought. And I don't think it was really bad, so I went upstairs. My husband's super critical, and he's very Dutch, he'll always say what he thinks. Very honest guy. So I go, like, my knees are still shaking, I go, then I said to Rob, so how was it? And he's like, it's really good. And I'm like, oh. And it showed, because that show did a lot for me in Holland. And then you guys came to my show, and I was touring with the band, and it was like a heavy show. I did a heavy show, and I could really pick out people, you with sweaters on, because all my audience is like metal shirts or whatever, guys with makeup, and then people like you. So we call them David Day's, the name of the show, David Day Sweaters. I saw a few people, and then they discovered me through the show, and then some of them just kind of halfway walked out of the venue like, oh, it's way too loud for me, this. Because they thought I did like acoustic shows. But anyway, long show. So does anybody have a certain time that they have to be home? To go, how do you say, to pay the nanny? Okay, so, you two, all I want is you.
Treasure just to look up on me.
say you give me.
In a Dutch language, actually. It's about letting go of the old and starting the new. We all have to deal with that in any shape or form. The people from Russia, I'm sorry, I can't. One day I'll write a song in Russian language. No. I couldn't. Actually, no.
Zet de dag naar jou aan.
Je weet ook dat ik jou graag mag. Morgen is een hele nieuwe dag. Thank you. 80s, another song from the 80s. I was an 80s kid, because I'm 42, and I have my my aunt. My aunt is here today, Tante Dor. Where are you? Ik zie je niet. Oh, de laatste is helemaal daar. Dat is goed. Oké. So my aunt and my uncle are here. And I have a little story because when I was very, very young, I used to sleep over Tante Doortje's house a lot. And I loved being at your place because she has small feet. So when I was there, I was a young girl, and I would fit almost in her shoes. So I always was in front of the mirror in the bedroom with the Tante Doortje shoes on, with the clothes on, and I was like singing, you know, doing the Madonna thing and the whole thing in front of the mirror. And she opened up a boutique clothing store, and so then I was in front of the mirror with all the clothes from the shop, and she was in do the whole Madonna thing. So I loved being in her house and under her care, and she used to drive the old car of my grandmother. It's a Duff, you know, one of those square. Was it white? A square white car, and make a lot of noise. And we used to drive, I don't know, we should go do groceries or whatever. And then, so there was also always one song on the radio, and my aunt always said, sing that song, you have to sing it. And I sang it when it was on the radio, but even if it wasn't on the radio, she said, you should sing this song, you know, for her. So I a lot of times I sang this. Do you remember which song it was? It's a long time ago. But I recently heard it, because you always hear it on the radio, it's a big hit. And I remembered this story, and I thought, why not just kind of integrate it in my solo set? So it's Broken Wings from Mr. Mister. And so Tante Dor asked me, hey, sing that song again. Okay. Here we go, Tante Doortje. Also the first time today. Yeah. God circles. Sad song, because we will end on a happy note, right? Yeah.
Yeah, listen to Sensor.
Yeah. Not another story. No, no, please, no.
My scribblings.
It's actually Cindy Lauper, time after time.
Okay, good. Okay, when the time we get there is like 4 in the morning,
The meatballs are not meatballs anymore. They look like extraterrestrial things from outer space. They look like unidentified floating objects. Floating in gravy. And they're like sponges. They're like... So, the other day, one of our guitar players, Joris, he took a meatball and he cut it open and it was like lots of mayonnaise. And we had played, you know, a long day, he was tired but also hungry, so I ate one. And he ate one really fast. And he turned to me and says, "Anneke, I don't feel so good." I know yours because of the meatball, man. It's good. So anyway, so, but you know, something else, like a bottle of water, Snickers. So if you buy a CD, I have money for a bottle of water. Okay, so that was my sales rep. I'll sing you a song. If you join me, that would be great. And I'll see you later in the lobby lounge or whatever it's called. And again, thank you so much for being here.
Jolene.
Now you messed up my set. Now I'm getting insecure about my set. No. But it's true. It's actually not a happy song. But it's... We make it a happy song, right? So, yeah. So... Actually, I didn't anticipate this. Shall we do a happy song?
Yes.
Let me think. Hey, okay.
Yeah!
Okay, here we go. Didn't rehearse this all too much. Thank you, guys. Here we go.
Thank you.